My name is Danielle Friel Otten. I proudly serve the people of Central Chester County in Pennsylvania's 155th Legislative District. And today, I humbly stand before you as the House Chairwoman of Pennsylvania's Legislative Climate Caucus. The people have a right to clean air, pure water, and the preservation of the natural, scenic, historic, and aesthetic values of the environment. That's Article 1, Section 27 of Pennsylvania's state constitution. The Pennsylvania Legislative Climate Caucus convenes to research, evaluate, discuss, and raise awareness about legislation, appropriations, and related matters in ways that affirm evidence-based, peer-reviewed science. The acceptance that climate change is real and human-made. The importance of environmental justice and the necessity for a renewable energy future. The Climate Caucus operates to uphold the charge of environmental stewardship as laid bare in Article 1, Section 27 of Pennsylvania's Constitution. As members of the Climate Caucus, we are committed to doing all we can to build a Commonwealth that is stronger, more resilient, more equitable, and more sustainable. As we work together to position Pennsylvania as a climate leader, we need meaningful and comprehensive rules that will allow us to reach the greenhouse gas reduction goals of 26% by 2025 and 80% by 2050 from the 2005 levels as outlined in Governor Wolf's January 2019 Climate Action Executive Order. Oil and gas development cast an extensive and still growing footprint across our state. Whether it is the tens of thousands of conventional wells that have been in operation for decades, the proliferation of unconventional wells and their vast network of associated infrastructure in more recent years, or the build-out of new natural gas generation facilities, oil and gas activity continues to climb in Pennsylvania with no slowing down. The reality is that wherever oil and gas are being drilled, compressed, processed, or sent through pipelines, climate warming methane is leaking and polluting our air. To compound this, we have only incomplete estimates as to how big the problem is now or how large it will be in the future. Pennsylvanians are already experiencing the dangerous climate change impacts in an increase in extreme weather events, which have caused flooding, landslides, and even an increase in ticks that carry Lyme disease. Given that we are experiencing record production from wells large and small, the proposed methane rule is urgently needed, but it still falls short. As currently written, the draft rulemaking provides two acute exemptions from requirements to find and repair leaks of dangerous climate warming pollution. Please help us make Pennsylvania a leader in tackling climate change by implementing the most comprehensive and protective methane rules possible. Reducing methane and other pollutants from oil and gas operations is a fundamental piece of the climate action puzzle, one that must be addressed by Pennsylvania and the oil and gas industry. The people have a right to clean air, pure water, and the preservation of the natural, scenic, historic, and aesthetic values of the environment. We are asking Governor Wolf and the DEP to ensure that our efforts to address climate change do not fall short. We are urging them to close the loopholes that allow nearly half of the methane emissions from oil and gas operations to go unchecked and to maintain consistent and frequent inspection requirements. For far too long, the people of Pennsylvania have carried the burden of the externalities of extractive industries that impact their health, welfare, and safety, and then leave our communities gutted in cycles of boom and bust. It's time for Pennsylvania to act on climate and build a better, healthier, safer, and more prosperous future for generations yet to come. Through a just transition to a clean energy economy that leaves no one behind. Thank you so much.